Here you go. Everything, guys. Good morning, hope you're all well. It's Thursday, 8th of December. I've come to a place called Bather, B-E-D-D-A-U, here in Wales. It's local to me. It's about 35 minutes drive. I'm going to be doing just a day session because I'm back in work tomorrow. So I've come down to a place called Trinant Fishery, better known in Wales as Joncos. There's three lakes on the complex, two are a mixture of fish, all coarse fish, and one is a carp lake. So I've chosen the carp lake today. So it's £10 for two rods. Cracking margin fishing here, absolutely brilliant. I have brought some spod mix with me. I was thinking of making my own little feature out in the middle somewhere, you know. Well, we'll see how it goes now, and I've got a mixture of baits. No doubt they'll change a few times through the day. I'm gonna have a walk around the lake now. See if I can see anything. I'm the only angler on at the moment, see? And when I spoke to John when I came in, I'd say better known as Jonko, lovely man he is, absolutely amazing. What a nice man, like. When I spoke to John, he said it's very quiet down here. So I said, what do you mean? The fishing or what? Like, he said, oh no, he said, not many anglers been coming here. So there's a sign that the cold weather started, right? So I'm gonna have a walk around the lake now and see if we can spot any fish. I have brought my deeper with me, so I might chuck that about a few times now, okay? See you in a bit, guys. So I've chosen peg 10, guys. I've had to walk all the way around the lake. This is actually a peg I normally fish. Movement yet, but I think just stick to what I know. What I normally do when I fish this peg, I fish the opposite margin. So here we go now, right? So this is Kingfisher Lake, guys. So it'll be noted on the website as the bottom lake. This is top, middle and bottom. This is the bottom lake. Okay. So here's some of the baits I brought with me today. I've got some dead maggots. And I use them dead so they don't crawl away. Got my usual spod mix. And I got switch crumb. I've added some switch crumb into my spod mix. Thank you. up on the shell. So what I'm going to do now is I've clipped up the spod rod with the deeper on because the stick's out. I've got the distance six out, so I'm just going to clip up. I'm going to fish on top of that shelf at 6 foot, and it was activity in there. So that was 8 drops. So I'm going to put the spotter now. I'm just going to put 2 spobs full over the top. And I set the rod up. So I've collected the spom. I've got a finger store on. I'm just going to wet the eyes with the rod now and dunk the reel in the water. Okay? Fish today little and often, okay? So every so often I'll be pulling out 2 spots. Don't forget your finger saw, guys. I'll take the finger right down to the bone. So here's my rigs, guys. I've just got a krill pellet. Got a little bit of foam underneath just to give it a little bit of buoyancy so it sits up like a wafter. What I've done with the foam nugget, just cut it down the middle with the scissors, put the rig inside, which is a combi rig, by the way, fluorocarbon, supple braid, and I've just squeezed it on. Okay, that'll come off pretty easy. A lead system, we've all seen it before. It's a semi-fixed running lead. Okay, let's get fishing. So I've clipped up my first rod now with 8 traps. If you notice, I've put the lid of a bucket down because I don't want the hook bait picking up any scents off the earth, and also to keep the PBA mega dry. Right guys, we're fishing. Hit the clip, felt the lead down, went down with it, not too bad a drop. It's definitely soft out there, clay. Fishing slack lines. I've sat right on the rods, and as you can see, that white marker there, that's what I've aimed for. So I've given myself a marker and I've pointed the rods more or less right to them. Okay, let's get a brew on a go. So I've set up another rig ready to go out. So what I've done, I've got a 12mm PB prop up. I've balanced it in the water so the hook is laying flat on the lake bed. And the pop up is just hovering above, you know, sitting like a wafter. I'm also going to do the same in the second rod with the Fruit Delicious pop up. See if colour will draw them in. I say I'll try a few things until We're in, guys, we're in. So as I was wrapping up that first rod that took the fish, the other rod went on the PB pop-up cut down. So it's bright colours that's doing it today, you see? Orange and yellow. So I'll put all the other baits away now and I'll just fish them. But point to note is I did use Tutti Frutti Goo on the hook bait. Okay, so if you're coming down here, fruity and bright colours. Right guys, hope that helps. So there you go, look, bottom lip nailed. There you go. I'm not going to bother having a picture with it, right? So I'll show you one here.
and 12, 13 pound.
Look. Genie. 10 mil fruit delicious with some tutti frutti gold. So what I do now, I put both rods on that, see? So what I got here, the size 8, long shank hook. I got a long section of shrink tube, supple braid to an all bright knot, covered in putty, and then I got 5 inches of fluorocarbon. Tail rubber on the end, look. So it sits like, imagine my trousers there, bottom of the lake, okay? Sitting flat like that. And pop up just. So there's the second fish, guys. Another common. With 15 pound. 10 mil fruit delicious pop up. Tutti frutti goo.
See on the back.
Just hovering above. I'm just going to show you an alternative way to use a solid bag. So I've got some switch crumb in there with some pellets, okay, and I've put some of the tutti frutti goo in there. So I'm going to seal the bag now. So seal the bag, okay. And a lick along the middle. And lay my rig in there. Fold it over like. I'd rather do it like that, using PVA bags rather than mesh this time of year, because it melts a lot quicker. Because the water's so cold, sometimes it can take up to 5 minutes with stocking, you know, mesh. So that's why we use solid bags. It's just an alternative way of using them. Okay? So I've just replenished the spot, guys, with another 3 spoms straight on the spot. So the 2 fish now have both taken the fruit delicious, which is an orange and fruity, and I've also put on tutti frutti goo, okay, and a little bag of pellets and crumb. That method I showed you with the alternative way of using a solid bag. Right guys, I'll keep you updated. about 15 minutes now, guys. And there you go, guys. There we go, we're in, guys.
We're in.
Number six in the retainer, guys. I got another one on. Carnage. Oh, there's another one in the net. It's really small. Fruit delicious again, look. I won't bother recording him, I just came straight back, right? So three to the fruit delicious. Grown DNA baits. Absolutely gorgeous. Probably the first time he's been caught. There's something on his peck fin there, look. Nailed in the bottom lip. Number three. It's 1 o'clock now. It started raining, all right? So, the extra oxygen in the water now. From previous experience down here, the rain usually switches them on. So keep updated, guys, right? Is fish number four, guys. Took a pink peril. Tell him to pop up, trim down. About 12 pounds all. No count. So it's 20 to 4 now, guys. I've had four fishes, you know. But I've had 8 runs. Yeah, I've had 8 runs. Pink peril is doing it now. It's all down to do with the light then, you know. The light then, I think. Like as I say, some days you come down, yeah. You catch them on just a boil out of a bag, like they wouldn't touch a bright fluoro, like, but you know, you gotta bring a multiple choice of baits, like, and try them. So that's what I did in the beginning, like. Trying to unlock our code, but it's bright colours today, it's very overcast, it's low pressure, light rain, I wouldn't call this heavy rain at all, it's light rain, yeah, but it seems to be bright colours on this day, see, there you go, so I'll keep updated, I'll probably fish till 4:30, you got to get out there, see, before it gets dark, which is fine, yeah, but it's been a great day so far. I say I've had 8 runs, it's fantastic for autumn, just about to go into winter. People are still saying they're on the winter campaign, it's not winter yet, guys. You've got about another week to go yet, then you can call it winter, right? Not trying to be funny or nothing, but it's still autumn. Catch you later. So that's what the goo does to the water, look. See? It's like a halo. And it stains your fingers. Yeah, see? It's bound to attract the fish, innit? It's got a room, man. This is number 5, boys and girls. Another mirror, pink pearl, drop down. £11. Take a morning weather, I guess, isn't it? Let's get back on the spot. Happy days. Let's get her back. Yeah, as I said, it's when it starts raining, you know, they usually kick off. Look, so we're on 5 fish now, guys. Stop raining for now. Very, very overcast. It's great, perfect conditions, guys. Couldn't ask for it better, to be honest. There's two guys on the other side. I haven't seen them having anything yet. Still all to play for, got an hour left, guys. I'll keep you updated. So here's number 6, guys. So there you go, guys. I'm gonna pack up now and get out there before it gets dark. So we finished on 6 fish. I bullied the last one in, to be honest, because there was one on the retainer, like on the mat. So I bullied the last one in, and he was a mirror carp, probably about £14, and I lost it. So that's it. I'm gonna pack up now, but I'll give an update when I get back to the van. Right, see you in a bit. Right, guys, I'm back in the van, all packed up, ready to go home to see my little girl Lily Boo. Finished off on 6 fish. Had numerous runs as well. The heavens opened this afternoon, which was really switched them on, it did. So bear that in mind when you come here, guys. They love the rain, yeah. They do love the rain. So let's sum it up then. We chucked the deeper out to start, and we found a 6-foot shelf going down to 7.5 foot. So I fished both rods on top of the shelf. I wasn't quite sure how the fish would react to match the hatch sort of baits to start off with, and nothing occurred. So I put fluros on and started getting runs. So I switched them all over then to the fluros. Great day out down here, guys. Especially this time of year, you know, when it's getting difficult on larger waters. Like, there's nothing wrong with coming to waters like this time of year. You know, keep your confidence up and keep it bending the rod, like. Yeah, so this is called Trinant. It's in Beda in South Wales. It's better known to locals as Jonko's. That's John's nickname, the owner. It's £10 for two rods for the day. There's no night fishing here. There's 3 lakes, Mallard, Kingfisher, and something else. Can't remember the other one, to be honest. But two of the lakes are coarse fishing lakes, you know, with like bream and perch and all what have you in them. And the kingfisher one I fish on today is only carp, so it'd be a good idea for you to bring particles, you know, which I did today. Do your homework, guys, okay? It always pays off. So I'm gonna head home now. I hope I've given some pointers, you know, especially for the local lads that fish down here, like. You know, it's a bit far to come over the bridge for the day session, but for the local lads, I hope I've shared some knowledge with you today. Right, so hope you give us a like and definitely comment, guys. Be interesting one, isn't it? Yeah, and if you haven't already subscribed, be most grateful, guys, if you subscribe. Right, so I'm gonna head out now, guys. It'll take me about 35 minutes, depending on traffic, of course. I'm gonna hit the works traffic now, so might be 6 hours, like. But there you go, right? So I've had a fabulous day. Back in work tomorrow now. But I'll see you on the next one, guys. I really, really hope you enjoyed this vlog. I really enjoyed making it. Ta-ra, guys.